हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड हेल्दी। आई एम मिसेस पेट्रिशिया डोमिनिक, योर सोशल स्टडीज टीचर, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द फर्स्ट लेसन, अर्थ एंड एनवायरनमेंट पार्ट टू। चिल्ड्रेन, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंट फिजिकल रीजन्स ऑफ पाकिस्तान एंड डिफरेंट लैंड फॉर्म्स। Today we will learn about the similar physical regions in the other parts of the world, and we will compare the lives of people in these regions. Let's explore some physical regions of the world similar to those found in Pakistan. Mountains. Here are two pictures of mountains, K2 and Mount Everest. You must have heard about these two big and giant mountains in the world. K2 lies in Pakistan and Mount Everest is in Nepal. Now, Mount Everest is the highest mountain of the world, and K2 is the second highest and Pakistan's first highest peak. The topography of Nepal and Pakistan is similar. Now let's see what is common in these two regions. Topography means features of a place or region. People make a living through agriculture, tourism, and cattle breeding. Look at these scenic views of Pakistan. Here are some valleys among the mountains and the people. In the mountainous regions of Pakistan, people make a living through agriculture and tourism. Tourism means when the people from other part of the world come and visit our beautiful places, and we earn through tourism. We make some hotels, inns, and make arrangements for the foreigners to stay in our valleys and different beautiful places in Pakistan. The scenic beauty of the mountain attracts tourists from all corners of the world. You can see these are two pictures of Pakistan. It is Nepal. In Nepal's mountains, the people's livelihood depends on arable agriculture and cattle breeding. They also engage in the sale of herbal medicines collected from the forest, and tourism is a good source of income for the people. So this is how the people of mountains in Pakistan and Nepal are same almost, because they have the same occupations. They are depending on agriculture, they are depending on tourism and beautiful scenes in these mountainous regions. Now see the plateaus. As I told you what plateaus are in the last lesson, plateaus of Pakistan, and here the plateaus of Iran. They have the common features. Now what is common in the two regions? Both the regions have dry hills and which contain deposits of minerals and other natural resources like oil, natural gas, coal, limestone and gypsum. And people living in Pakistan and Iran engaged in agriculture. Many people work in oil drilling companies and refineries. This is some of the pictures of gems and a picture of coal mine and a salt mine. And you can see different gems here. They all are found in plateaus of Balochistan and Punjab. Here's the picture of coal, a picture of refinery, gypsum. This is the picture of rig, oil refinery in Iran. This is Attock oil refinery near Rawalpindi. This is Khera salt mine in Punjab. This is Arak oil refinery in Iran. People living in plateau regions of Pakistan and Iran engaged in agriculture. Many work in the quarries and the oil drilling companies as well as in refineries. Now see the plains. A rice field in the Indus Plain, Pakistan, and the other picture is mustard field in the Gangetic Plains, India. Children, I told you that plains are lying near the rivers. All the places near the Indus River are called Indus Plains, and the places in India near the Ganges River, they are called Gangetic Plains. Mustard field, and in Urdu it is called Sarson. Look how beautiful it looks. Both the plains, Indus and Gangetic, are similar. Now we are going to see what is common in the two regions. They are fertile and densely populated. People are engaged to agriculture, and both the regions grow two types of crops in a year, the Kharif and the Rabi. The Kharif crops grown in summer, it include cotton, rice, maize, millet and sugarcane, as you can see in the picture. And in Rabi, it grows in winter and include wheat, pulses, grams and mustard. So these are the main crops which are grown in both the plains of Pakistan and in India. So this is common in the two regions. Let's see the deserts. The Thar Desert, Pakistan, and the Sahara Desert in Africa. So our desert in Pakistan very similar to the Sahara Desert in Africa. Let's see what is common in the two regions. Both the deserts lie more or less in the same latitude, between 23 to 25 degree north. Children, we will prepare one more lesson upon latitude and longitude, and then you will come to know about this degrees and the location on the globe, how we find and locate some different places on the globe. People of these regions depend on what little agriculture is possible in the oasis. What oases are? In the desert, where some water is found in a small area, that is called oasis. The inhabitants of these regions depend on what little agriculture is possible and grazing for animals. Most of the people are engaged in raising livestock such as cattle, camels, donkeys and goats. Life in the desert is harsh and difficult because of the climate and lack of water. This is the picture of Pakistan's Thar Desert. Now here see delta. Delta, children, you know what delta is, where the river flows its water into the sea from the smaller body to the bigger body. Here are two pictures of deltic plains, the Indus Delta in Pakistan and the Nile Delta in Egypt. Now let's see what is common in between. There is another delta, Mississippi, America, that is also very much similar to the delta of Indus. The common in between in these deltic plains is that people living in these regions can earn a living through fishing. This is the picture of mangrove forest. They are found in Pakistan. The Indus Delta in Pakistan is similar to the Nile Delta in Egypt, and they both form the shape of a bird's foot when they flow into the Arabian and Mediterranean seas, respectively. And the Mississippi and the Indus Delta are good breeding places for prawns, shrimp, and fish. So people living in these regions can earn a living through fishing. So here in where the mangrove forests are, it is a very good place for the breeding of prawns. The Indus Delta is rich in mangrove forests. Now let's come to the homework. You have to answer these following questions. Write the names of the similar regions in different parts of the world. How do the people living in mountainous regions of Pakistan and Nepal make a living? And what are Kharif and Rabi crops? Name the crops grow in each type. So this is for your homework. Children, you can submit your homework in school. Complete it on full scape sheet. Thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe.